Hello bookish friends, welcome to another Turkish Shelf video. In this video I will talk about a Turkish book that was translated to English, which I finished quite recently, which is Piri Lezzet by Saygın Ersin, and it was translated to English as Pasha of Cuisine. Saygın Ersin was born on February 5th, 1975 in Manisa. He is the son of a teacher couple. After he finished his high school in the same city, he studied sociology in the Middle East Technical University. After a brief period of journalism, he became an author. His first novel was Zülfikar'ın Hükmü, followed by Erbain Fırtınası. Those two being the first two books in Yedi Kartal Efsaneleri, which can be roughly translated as Seven Eagles Legend. He then published a short story collection featuring elderly detectives titled Emekli Polisler Lokali. He co-wrote Derin İmparatorluk with Orkun Uçar. The last book he published, Piri Lezzet, became a success and was translated to many different languages, including English, of course. The author also wrote scenarios for historical fiction comics and worked as a plot and scenario writer in various TV series and movies. Ersin currently lives in Izmir and he apologizes everybody for having such a boring biography in the cover of his books. Piri Lezzet was published by April Yayıncılık in 2016. It was translated to German, English, Polish, Dutch, Bulgarian, Arabian, Urdu, Georgian and Macedonian. The English edition, Pasha of Cuisine, was published by Arcade Publishing in 2018. The book was translated by Mark Wires. I will read the Goodreads synopsis, which I liked very much and suited the general atmosphere of the book very, very much. A Pasha of Cuisine is a rare talent in Ottoman lore. Only two, maybe three, are born with such a gift every few centuries. A natural master of gastronomy, he is the sovereign genius who reigns over aromas and flavors and can use them to influence the hearts and minds, even the health of those who taste his creations. In this fabulous novel, one such chef devises a plot to bring down the Ottoman Empire, should he need to, in order to rescue the love of his life from the Sultan's harem. Although there are many very interesting characters in the book, there are mainly three characters that I want to talk about. The first one is, of course, Aşçıbaşı, master chef, whose name is not revealed until the end of the book. He is actually the survivor of a bloodiest massacre ever recorded within the imperial palace after the passing of the last sultan. He is spirited away through the palace kitchens, where his potential was recognized. Across the empire, he is apprenticed one by one to the best chefs in all culinary disciplines and trained in related arts such as the magic of spices, medicine and the influence of the stars. Kamer is the love of Aşçıbaşı's life. They meet when they are in their early teens and they fall in love. From a very delicate child, she grows to be a very beautiful, fiery and stubborn woman who earns her life in dancing. She then rises to the harem and becomes a favorite among the imperial harem, but she never forgets her first love. Our third character, although a side character, he is a very beloved character for me. Abdullah Chef. He is an elderly chef in the palace. He is the father figure of Aşçıbaşı. He hides his identity and tries to protect him when he is a child. Although Aşçıbaşı is born talented with exquisite sense of taste, Abdullah Chef teaches the basics of how to cook to him. And Aşçıbaşı devises his revenge plan. Abdullah Chef tries to both calm him and also help him in the necessary steps in his revenge. And what did I think about the book? When I first heard about the book, I thought it would be a book that I would like because I generally like historical fiction books. But I never thought that I would be so much pleasantly surprised by this book. When I started listening to the audiobook, I felt like I was listening to a fairy tale told by our elderly relatives, which is a very common practice in Turkey. And I also really fell in love with the writing style. Plot was very interesting, but the structure of the plot made it much, much more engaging to listen to. First, start with a present point in time, and then the story of Aşçıbaşı is told from the flashbacks coming in chronological order, as well as progressing through the point that we started the book. And when those two storylines finally emerge in some point, climax and the conclusion of the book is then presented. But, some of the details of the plot, which explained so many things about the relationship between food, health, earth elements, and even astrology, those parts were fascinating to read about. Because the historical fiction becomes even much more enjoyable for me to read when I learn new things. And I also really liked the complexity of the characters. The characters had their faults, which made them much more relatable. Like I said in the character part, I really loved the elderly chefs who advised Aşçıbaşı with their wisdom. Complex dynamics of the relationship was really a joy to read. Although I found the romance to be effective enough for me to root for Aşçıbaşı's plan, I did not think that it was a love tale of epic proportions, to be honest. And I also found the conclusion of the book a bit disappointing because the follow-up up until the point was done so perfectly. I was expecting much, much more, but I do not want to scare you. It was really a solid, very good ending. I have recommended this book very, very passionately to all of my friends, and I'm very, very glad that this book was translated to English, so that I would recommend the book to my international friends. It is sort of like a Monte Cristo story taking place in the Ottoman Empire. Overall, I gave the book a 9 out of 10. It was one of the best books that I've read so far that is translated to English. As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose spice. Spice means baharat in Turkish, and baharat is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!